A truly enormous earthquake has just struck offshore of Russia's Kamchatka Peninsula, and now the entirety of the west coast of the continental United States and most of Alaska are under a tsunami warning, tsunami advisory, or tsunami watch. Potentially destructive tsunamis with wave heights of 1 to 3 meters or 3.3 to 9.8 feet are now possible across all of Hawaii, while in Japan, tsunami wave heights east of Tokyo may approach around 3 meters in height. In fact, at the present, there aren't too many countries in the entire Pacific Ocean which aren't under a tsunami alert of some sort. Get away from the coastline in all of these regions and do not attempt to watch a tsunami nor go out in curiosity if and when you see the sea retreat, as that will be your warning that a large tsunami wave is imminent. If you live in the United States and are curious what you should do, visit this website. The reason for such a vast array of tsunami alerts was Russia just experienced its second largest earthquake in recorded history, while also representing the planet's largest single earthquake since 2011. This quake struck at 11:24 a.m. local time on July 30th, approximately 84 miles or 135 kilometers east-southeast of where the vast majority of Kamchatka's population lives, the city of Petropavlovsk-Kamchatsky. Now, I want to note that the U.S. Geological Survey damage and casualty estimate figures are merely educated guesses from a computer program, and these can be wildly inaccurate. With that in mind, it is predicting a highest likelihood based on current available data of between $10 billion and $100 billion U.S. dollars in damage having been caused, mostly in Russia, and between 10 and 100 fatalities. There are already videos circulating showing at least a 6-meter-high tsunami striking a portion of Kamchatka's eastern coastline, and this situation is still developing. This could be incredibly destructive, but at least this earthquake does not appear to be a cataclysm of the same magnitude that Japan's 2011 earthquake was. That 2011 Japan earthquake, by the way, caused 22,000 fatalities and $500 billion in damage. But, back to the current situation. The earthquake was a true megathrust event, plain and simple. It was caused by an ongoing tectonic plate collision east of Kamchatka, where the Pacific plate is subducting underneath the Okhotsk plate. Over time, stress built up on the Okhotsk plate due to friction from the subducting underlying plate pulling it downwards into the mantle. This stress built up until it overcame the friction being applied to it, causing what was likely a 390-kilometer or 242-mile-long portion of the Okhotsk plate to snap back upwards. This motion displaced overlying water, generating a damaging tsunami. Let us hope that the damage is not as severe as the USGS model forecasts. I also want to note that for once, this megathrust earthquake was preceded by hundreds of foreshocks, including a magnitude 7.3 earthquake that struck the exact same area only 10 days ago. Only about 1 in 20 earthquakes worldwide represent a foreshock, so what happened here was unusual. Megathrust earthquakes are uncommon, and earthquakes of this magnitude, specifically an 8.8 or larger, have only occurred 8 times in the last 125 years, so what happened today is rare. I will give an update on the ongoing situation tomorrow when I have more information on the extent of damage today's earthquake has caused. Please stay safe, everyone.